Hello. This is our fifth weekly trek in. We're the Trekyeah boys. I'm Walker. This is Evan, and that's Andy. Our mic stand today is a Dasani water bottle. It is Coca-Cola product, but that's cool. One thing that I want to go into is how much the. Anyways, it was a good week this week. It's been relaxing. It's been interesting as like a liminal period in between finishing up the course and trying to find jobs, which we'll go into.
I'm going to get sunburned.
Yeah.
Living with a guy with red hair.
Yeah.
You want to switch? Okay.
Oh, yeah. I guess we just cropped in there.
It's all right.
I got sunburned earlier for the first time here. Sorry, Mom.
It's mine. I already switched it.
Perfect. You want to just talk about sunburn?
That's one of our things. Yeah, I got sunburned. That's pretty much it.
Yeah. Nice little bro tank tan. And it was just for being out here recording. We've been doing interviews with people.
And I have not been wearing sunscreen at all here because I haven't needed to. I think it's because like the pollution or something of our area was bad enough to where like you wouldn't really get sun. But here I've definitely been wearing sunscreen like on this patio.
Yeah, he got sunburned. We're still good. I'm the whitest kid you know, so...
Besides the widest kid,
yeah. So yesterday we had a big day. We went to the War Remnants Museum, which is in Ho Chi Minh City, down in the center. And it's Evan would like to talk about it. I think most importantly,
these guys know that war history is one of my things. But one thing I don't think we've ever talked about before I even go into that is. Like the whole Saigon Ho Chi Minh thing.
Okay.
Right? Like sometimes we've called it Saigon, sometimes we've called it Ho Chi Minh. Some of you might understand why, but for those of you who don't, Saigon was the capital of the South Vietnam when the two were separated. And once Saigon was liberated, as they say, by the North Vietnamese army, they kind of as a slap in the face, they changed the name to Ho Chi Minh. Which is kind of the leader or the founder of the Communist Party in North or in Vietnam, among other things. He did a lot of stuff. But so, yeah, kind of a slap in the face. But people still call it Saigon. People will call it Ho Chi Minh. It's, I mean, the airport's letters are SGN.
Right. Right. So the river is called like Saigon River or something. So it's
really interchangeable, yeah. Especially down here. The South is still very... Saigonese, they call themselves Saigonese. You ask them, hey, where are you from? And they're like, I'm from Saigon. So, yeah, it's interchangeable.
Yeah, so...
Just don't get it twisted.
So it's technically Ho Chi Minh. Now, so we went to the War Remnants Museum, and we all have a little bit we'd want to talk about it, but, you know, it was really interesting to see the story from the other side. I also think the Vietnam War is a war that we don't really hear about much. We know a lot about World War II. I mean, good guys versus bad guys, D-Day, you know, but you don't hear much about Vietnam. And so it was really interesting to see. I think the things that stuck out for me at the museum was Agent Orange. For those of you, I'm sure everyone's heard it, and we all learned it in like middle school and history, whether you remember it or not, but Agent Orange was a chemical that was dropped on rainforest in Vietnam because to destroy the forest so that the North Vietnamese, the Viet Cong, were exposed. And so the South and the U.S. could fight them better. Anyway, it was said to only kill plants and have no effect to humans, but that was extremely wrong. And it caused a lot of different issues for people who were directly affected. And
it's still causing issues generations
it's
down.
It's infamously bad for birth defects. It's kind of, it affects the genes. So we saw so many pictures of people who've been affected, first generation, second generation, or even the third generation. Obviously those numbers dwindle as the time goes on. But
terrible pictures. Haunting
terrible.
Pictures.
Yeah. Like shit that you would see in Guinness, like... Ripley's Believe It or Not,
yes.
That
or
kind
like
of stuff.
The Hills Have Eyes.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
More right.
Yeah,
it.
For sure.
And it was pretty hard to see, you know, that. But so worth looking into how many people that's affected. knowing that that was a thing that happened.
One thing about Agent Orange is, according to the museum, like, it's the most toxic chemical that they've found. They've, like, discovered the dioxin in Agent Orange. It takes, like, 82, I can't remember if it's milligrams or grams, and that's kind it's of grams. Important. Grams. 82 yeah. grams of it can wipe out an entire city. So
I think, to be fair, I think the dioxin is only a portion of the Agent Orange.
Yeah.
And so, right, so there's just such a minuscule amount. But,
mm-hmm.
so
yeah, I no, think, it is, yeah. But that, like, that part of it is, like, the... Yeah.
Yeah, and actually, and so it affects both Vietnamese and Vietnam veterans. I mean, there's been people in the U.S. affected by this, as well as the U.S.'s allies, like South Korea and stuff. I know there was a big lawsuit a couple of years back, 10, 20 years, I'm not sure, against, like, Monsanto and
Dow,
yeah,
chemical.
Over, because they were the ones who were producing it. And I know that the U.S. Veterans won, but that didn't include people in Vietnam. And I don't believe people in Vietnam have ever received any financial, what do you call those?
Reprimands.
Reprimands, thank you, yeah.
Reprisals. Yeah, the War Museum was... It was really good from what I was hearing from people. I was actually, like, maybe, like, a bit underwhelmed as far as, like, because, you know, like, you go to maybe, like, a museum in the U.S. and there's, like, all these kind of, like, there's, like, interactive things and there's, like, all these, it's, like, maybe a little more, like, high-tech. Like, this is, like, very, like, you know, there were guns and there were, you know, helicopters outside and it was cool, but, like, inside it was all, like, it's pictures and it's text, and you're walking and you're reading and you're looking and you're walking, reading and looking. That being said, I cried at parts of it, so it wasn't, like, underwhelming by mm-hmm. any means. The part that really got me was seeing the pictures of the parents with their kids and dealing with, like, you know, like, their kids with deformities or, like, their kids with, like, no legs. There was one picture specifically of a woman nursing her child, and her child had its, like, legs blown off, and she was like in a hospital, and the little text under it was explaining how she told the photographer to take a picture of this because it was so, like, she wanted people to see. So there was definitely, like, there were emotional times in the museum for sure.
Yeah, and I think, especially being here and living here and getting a little bit of a community
at
this point. Getting a little bit of a community at this point, it was, you know, you see just the humanity of the, you know, in the U.S. there were all the propaganda of, you know, the Viet Cong is the enemy, these are the enemy, but it's really, it's just people. And so you see these pictures and you see, like, the same scenes that we see walking down the street, but just thrown into a hell. And you see the same people, like, selling dried shrimp that are just, you know, lying on the ground. You see the smiles, you see the people, and you can't help but put the faces of people that you know from Ho Chi Minh City into those pictures and imagine what it was like. That was hard for me. I think seeing... An interesting thing was, like, seeing just the, like, seeing smiles in some of the pictures. And there were...
The one, I know, I'm not sure.
There's one with a dog that was smiling, but that was, like, after the fact. I can't, you want to explain that? Because I don't know exactly
what
you're talking about.
There was, the one I was talking about was when, I'm not going to go into it, because I could just blabber on about
yeah.
it. But
we'll just make it quick, make it 30 seconds or so.
I don't know, photographers, sometimes on the battlefield, when you're not in the middle of a zone, there was pictures of, like, you know, where the photographer is taking a picture of soldiers and they're just, like, happy to get their picture taken.
Yeah.
And that was, like, it gave them personality.
Yeah.
But, you know, war's an awful thing, and, you know, I've read plenty about it. We all have. We've all seen plenty of it. It's just, it was also, one last thing to talk about is it's interesting to see how the other side tells the story of history. Because, you know, the truth often lies somewhere in the middle of the two. But yeah, I mean, what we hear in the U.S. isn't always right. If you're ever bored, check out Oliver Stone's Untold History of the United States.
Sponsored.
Yeah. But yeah, so I think that's a good wrap up there.
It was a really good trip to the museum though, yeah. And if you guys are in town, you definitely should go.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We're drinking Asian Red Bull too. which
tastes identical, but there's no carbonation.
It's yes. interesting.
One thing that my kind pops brought up the other day is something that we should do is on our next episode. Wanted to bring it up early on. Is if you guys have any questions about anything we've ever talked about or anything you've ever seen, like comment in this video or you know message us on Instagram, Facebook, whatever, and we'll spend time answering people's questions next episode.
For sure.
But yeah, so that wraps up that one. Let's move on to the next.
Yeah, to contrast that kind of stark war museum thing, we've been playing a lot of hacky sack.
Yeah, we have.
A lot of hacky sack. In our little like foyer down here in our Airbnb, and it gets real hot. So like, minutes in, we'll be stripped down to our underwear, just hacky sacking away. Getting pretty good.
We're getting better. It feels like we're in middle school again. Yeah. It's great.
Yeah, it's been fun. Should we talk about the good cry?
Briefly.
Well, I guess we are now.
Yeah. Okay, so. We were all sitting on this roof one day, and unexpectedly, we got into emotional conversations, and we started crying. And
a good cry.
We were all having a good cry together. And I know it's it's weird, you know. But I'm so proud to be able to say that like I can be with these guys, and we can like be so emotional and get so deep in things that we can just cry with each other. It's so weird.
Yeah, it is weird, but it's cool.
Yeah.
Just the fact that, you know, we know each other so well and we're comfortable with each other.
Nothing like a good cry with your buds.
So true. And
we all felt so much lighter.
We felt lighter, yeah. We talked about a lot of things, but the one thing that kicked it off and the one thing that started it, we were talking about my mom. She passed away a little over a year ago and talked about, you know, what I miss about my mom. And really kind of the summary of the conversation was about how easy it is to like it's the simple things that you take for granted and it's the simple things that you miss. And so the message of it all, or I love a lot of it, was I don't need my mom for X, Y, or Z right now. I mean, although that would be nice, but like in the end I just want to say hi to her. Like it's the weirdest thing. But the message was, and what we were getting so emotional about, is be present. Don't take your family for granted. When you're talking to them, talk to them, be interested in them, because you won't always have that. So anyway, figured it was worth bringing that message up because I think it's important.
Yeah,
for sure. Thanks, Evan.
Yeah, so the next one.
Hot Pockets.
Andy and I found our new favorite food.
Oh, yeah.
It's a street food. And what it is, it's like a little, I don't know, man.
This guy like rolls around this little stand and he's usually around. I don't know his hours. I don't know if he has hours, really. And, Evan showed me, and you go there, and he's got these little things, these little bread
it's
balls.
It's like dough balls.
Filled with, like, this sweet, like, sausage almost, and a hard-boiled quail egg. And if you can picture eating one of those pancake-wrapped sausages on a stick, it tastes exactly like that, but with some egg.
It's pretty sweet.
Sweet.
It's sweet. Like, oh, good.
Sweet
meat.
Yeah, it is really good.
So good.
Sweet, sweet meat.
And they cost 4K dong, which is just a not much.
A nice 13 cents, 15 cents.
15 cents.
And so we'll for dinner, we'll just grab 10 of them and just...
Bring them back, munch them.
Toss them back.
Toss them back.
Sweet, sweet street meat. So the other night we went to this concert down the road from the sweet, sweet street meat cart. It was this. Our street is lined with coffee shops.
It's more than lined. It's infested.
Yeah. Like there's actually, you go out and you can turn left or right and there's a coffee shop on each of those. There's coffee shops across the street from them, next to them, and all the way down the block. Like there must be an incredible market for it because they're always busy. There are always people.
All of them are filled, dude.
Yeah, but we went to one of them. It said acoustic show tonight at 8. So, we'll check it out. We went with some friends and ended up being really blown away. There was this, let's post the picture of that on our Facebook on trekyeah.
Yeah, we'll do that.
But we got there and we're like ordering a drink. We're like, I don't know how long we'll stay, maybe like 20 minutes or so, just hear it. And it was four young Vietnamese people, like
our age,
but maybe
our
a little
age.
Younger.
Yeah, a little younger, but pretty much
our age. And our age, yeah. And they just came out and fucking blew us away. Like, the voices on them, they were amazing.
Yeah, they were really good. They all spoke English, so they were like, this is our first time performing for foreigners, yeah. So we're a little nervous. And we didn't expect to hear that, of course. And, you know, they kind of explain, like, what they're going to do next in English to us, you know.
Yeah.
And it seemed like the other people there were kind of, like, friends with them, and yeah. they knew them, and it was kind of like they're just going seeing, like, their buddies kind of play this little gig, and then randomly, like, six other people showed up.
Six
as well.
White people. Yeah, the guy, I haven't heard a note this high in a while.
His falsetto was...
like, Minnie Riperton.
Was
if
brilliant.
If you know Minnie Riperton...
Yeah. Doodin, doodin,
I could never get
I was
that.
Waiting for my mug to shatter.
Yeah.
It was loud.
He was
high.
Unreal.
He was killing
it. It was good, though. It was really good.
Yeah. And it's interesting because he mentioned us, like, tagged us in a picture on Facebook that we'll repost. And he was like, you know, my friends tell me, they, like, make fun of me for hitting those high notes. They tell me I shouldn't do it. But you guys were so supportive. And it's like, dude, that is a specific talent that you have.
Yeah.
Dive
that
into
was
that.
Sick.
Milk that. Yeah, it was great, though. So they perform there every Saturday, so I think we'll be back. Oh, we're out of here on Saturday.
Yeah,
so
but
Saturday
who knows?
Is our last day at this Airbnb.
Yeah.
So.
It's also worth saying that on the Facebook picture, so like Facebook, Google Translate for Vietnamese is awful. I mean, we probably saw it on our Instagram. It's really bad. But luckily, Walker knows a girl who was able to translate a little bit of the comments on the picture. And the first one was some guy, I think he was gay, and was like, I know he was gay.
Yeah.
and was like, ooh, I like the guy standing next to the guy with long hair, which was Andy.
Yeah.
And then the singer girl who was singing that, I was like, oh, let's share, or something like that.
Yeah.
And
he proposed that they split up so the guy can have Andy like Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, and she gonna have him the other days. It was
so it's
just a piece of meat out here.
Really. Objectifying
the Renga.
You'll have that.
It's funny though.
Yeah.
And they sing a lot of English songs. They sing a lot of Adele. It was a mixture of Vietnamese.
My favorite was the Vietnamese
songs
though.
Vietnamese
those songs.
Were... like, I didn't want to request anything because I just wanted to hear them sing Vietnamese. Oh, our friend also sang with them.
Yeah.
And she's like a really good singer. And I think they were kind of surprised when she came up and she like started and they're all like, oh, what? That's
insane. They sang Titanium by, I think, Skrillex
is
the band.
Yeah, it was Skrillex, indie band.
I think Skrillex is the feature, but I think Surfcore is the overlaying producer.
The bass,
right.
The bass is Surfcore.
Yeah.
Surfcore influences. We've been pretty busy this past week having people over and people that we met in the course with just really interesting different backstories, people that come from all walks of life, and interviewing them. We're doing these deep deep conversations where we'll sit them down for an hour and a half. It's usually been about that. And we start off with like, who are you? What's your origin? What's your background? And then kind of like, why are you here? And where do you want to be? And we explore different topics throughout. But what I take away from it is it's really amazing that we've known these people for a while and it's a lot of small talk and hey, you know, the usual, you never get deep. But in these hour and a half conversations, we get to know these people so well.
Yeah.
And there's like, it's...
And just as a snapshot, we've interviewed a fashion designer who left a really lucrative job. We interviewed a guy who backpacked to Vietnam from France. Interviewed a guy who talks about getting violently robbed and mugged over and over again in Johannesburg, and a couple who's traveling the world together.
Yeah.
So like some really interesting
people. Married couple, married for 8 years.
Yeah.
From Mexico.
Yeah. It's been really, really we've said this multiple times, but even if we never were to do anything with those interviews.
And the audio's really bad on some of them.
Yeah,
because we're new at this,
we're
so
learning.
That might be the case.
We're podcast anubies.
Yeah.
Anubies. But even if we were to never do anything with those interviews, just the, like, we've built better relationships just by talking to these people in that format. It's amazing what having a microphone and an excuse and deliberately exploring these topics will do. It makes you kind of think about having these conversations in everyday life, and it might be a little too intense for people, but I'm going to start doing it.
We look forward to sharing them with you.
So, in the comments, explain the time you were most scared, the time you were most terrified, and then an embarrassing story, and tag your mom.
And tag your mom.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Our house, our last podcast, we're like, this house is so sick, and it is, it's a really cool house. Nice, I'm house. Happy to be here.
Yes.
But we've discovered some things about that are a little wonky. I'll let Evan tell you about the paint. He's the
paint guy. So I've been going off on this paint. They just
it's
keep
true,
making
though,
fun of me.
Man. I've not.
Thank you.
I understand.
Walker was making fun of me. So the paint, you touch it and there's a handprint. It doesn't matter like if you're like just lightly touching it. The walls get dirty so easy, and it's because, you know, Sherwin Williams veteran here, guys. It's like they paint the walls with ceiling paint, because like ceiling paint doesn't have any gloss. So it's not shiny. It's meant to like make your ceilings look bigger, and it doesn't matter. You don't care. But it's easier. It catches more friction, so it's easier for dirt to be caught off your hand. And ceiling paint tends to be cheaper. So the whole house is just painted with this cheap paint that doesn't have gloss. So the walls are just disgusting. We've been living here for a week, and they're already.
You touch it with the back of your knuckle, like clean, like apart, and it's like, well. That's coming out of the deposit.
Yeah.
Luckily, we didn't do any of that. So.
Also, playing hacky sack downstairs, the hacky sack gets so sweaty because we get so sweaty.
It's hot.
You get so sweaty.
I get really sweaty. Thanks, Sam Thompson, for giving me that gene. But, yeah, we'll get so sweaty. Our boxers will be saturated, I'm telling you.
I'm telling you.
Your boxers.
But, anyways, the sweaty hacky sack will hit the wall and just slide down and leave
it. Yeah,
it trick.
Sticks to the wall. It makes it a lot easier, really.
Yeah.
Psych.
But there's
also psych here. This we.
So we get down these weird rabbit holes. We've known each other for so long that sometimes we get in these ruts of communication where we just everything we say is like a continuation of this joke,
which is just. Psych, which is just like saying not.
Yeah.
Like, well, it's almost like when you say something and like other people don't think it's funny, so you say psych to like redeem yourself. They're like, oh, I didn't even want that to be funny. And
I didn't
like,
even
people...
not want that to be funny. Psych.
Yeah,
not.
Yeah, yeah. But here, and we'll do this as like, you know, cross your fingers when you're lying or something. But here, this means.
It means like fucking.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like.
So we'll run into
like
doing
something.
This in public a lot.
Yeah.
She's like, psych,
yeah,
psych!
Yeah, and then we'll have to be like, hey, easy, guys.
Yeah. So that's an interesting cultural difference.
Just kidding.
Other things with this house, though, we didn't have a stove for the first 4 days. There was no gas. They ended up having to buy an electric stove. They got to us later. The toilets...
Yeah, we still don't even use the stove.
No, the toilets didn't work for 2 days. We had to fill the tanks with the shower heads, which is nice, right? Because the toilets are right next to the shower.
Yeah.
So you could actually just fill the tank with the shower head. What else has happened here?
We didn't have, like, any bowls
or
silverware or towels or anything.
Yeah.
And the towels we ended up getting are just, like, little towels that you get for free when you buy a product at, like, a convenience store.
Yeah, they're
so
tiny little
just, like, little
hand
cloths.
Hand towels,
yeah.
Really.
Pretty funny.
Just Vietnam stuff, though, mostly.
Yep. Yep.
My room is very stuffy.
What would you put it at, Kelvin?
Kelvin?
Yeah.
At least 480.
Yo.
Look at
this.
Good work, bud. Walker walked in on Evan and I sharing an intimate moment the other day.
Oh. Yeah.
Go for it.
I don't even know what you're going to talk about.
So I come into their room, just, you know, what are my buddies doing? And I see them both lying on the bed in the fetal position, just lying
looking
there.
Into each other's eyes.
And so long story short, they were debroxing, putting this like these drops in their ear. I think it's to get high. The kids are the kids are doing it now.
I think they're getting stoned.
But anyways, they put this stuff in their ear and it like breaks up their earwax. They were supposed to include me in it last night.
We didn't.
I walked in and what are you guys doing? Yeah. Oh. So that's been weird.
Yeah, it's been awkward ever since.
Yeah, yeah. It really has. Yeah, dynamics never been the same.
It's amazing that we got together today to do this.
Besides that, our website is pretty much done, so it's going to be live today, and it's finally a thing. Big shout out to Colin Newhouse. He's been a huge help for us and will continue to be, unless he doesn't want to, of course, then he won't be.
Then he won't be.
That's a good point.
So drop your email into, there's a form on the website. Drop your email into that, and we'll send you some emails.
We'll spam the fuck out of you.
Yeah.
It'll be basically this, but in writing, shorter, easier to read. Because this is pretty hard to read. Straight to your inbox, so
boom. And you probably need the URL to access the internet.
Yeah, which we'll throw it in the show notes.
Yeah, passcode trekyeah.com.
Yeah.
All right.
The website is trekyeah.com. For those
that
don't speak Evan.
Passcodes.
Evan, another thing at the house, Evan's been really exceptionally scared of.
Yeah.
Not scared is the word, maybe.
Cautious.
Like, paranoid. I don't know.
These guys, we're living in some crazy place. So I tend to not be, I really am a trusting person. I mean, we're from Iowa, and so like I never lock my stuff, whatever. But you know, we're in Ho Chi Minh City, and we move into this house, and bunch of white people moving to one area, like I just feel like it's sort of suspicious, like
someone
might
be an
absolute
beacon.
Yeah, it's like, oh, look at all these people that probably don't know what they're doing, like let's steal their shit, you know, like, so I'm worried about it. These guys don't seem to care.
Well, I mean, you lock the stuff and then you go to bed, like there's nothing else you can do.
Well, I know, but these doors aren't locking up here, like there's still doors that are not locked in the
house.
You know,
if somebody climbs all the way up there, just have my shit, just take it.
I've just been piling it, I put it in a bag. Yeah. So don't have to mess with me, just take the stuff and go.
You leave a little note for him,
right?
Yeah. And so Evan's been, you know, losing sleep over people coming in. And
well, there was one night, because we briefly talked about the interview with the guy from Johannesburg.
Yeah.
He told us a story.
Oh, yeah, after that.
You'll have to hear it when you listen to it, but he told a story of when he ran into somebody who broke into his house and was, like, face-to-face with a guy. And so, of course, I have this in my mind, and I go to bed knowing that I'm not sure if anybody locked the front door. I know that the upstairs doors aren't locked. When a door closes in the house, it sounds like a bang, like
it
someone's
does.
Breaking in. And so, anyway, I'm like sitting here paranoid, like up till like 4 in the morning, like can't get sleep. Very unlike me, but
yeah,
pretty funny.
Unlike you.
There was a night where I come down to like get water at, it's probably like midnight. What do you think?
It's like 1:30.
1:30. I come downstairs to get some water, and I see Evan, because his room's so hot, he's sleeping naked with the door open, but he has, like, his laptop, he's, like, facing away from the door, his laptop's there, he's listening to his AirPods, he's listening to, like, an NPR Tiny Desk concert, which he's been loving. They're very quality. So he's doing that, he had, like, his phone in his hand, and I come up behind him, and I just, hey, are you watching porn? And he just, oh, God!
just so exposed.
Yeah. Yeah. Got him so good. So
I was
good.
Terrified.
Was so
and I just got off the phone. I was on the phone with Carly Beisel for like an hour and a half. And so like music had just started. You know, I was just getting back into the lull,
yeah.
You know. And anyway, pretty fun.
Yeah. Timing.
Timing and key. Good timing there, bud.
I got my saxophone fixed.
You did.
This was yesterday. So I, for those of you who don't know, I brought my alto saxophone that I haven't played in years out to Vietnam.
As a carry-on.
I was going to sell it before I left as I was selling all my things. And my grandpa, who I was living with, said, why don't you take it to Vietnam? As like I was like, well, that doesn't really make sense. But in my mind, I was thinking that. But instead, I just went, yeah. Yeah, okay. And so I brought it to Vietnam as my carry-on. And one of the keys was broken, so I got it fixed. Now it works well. It was kind of an interesting job getting it fixed because the saxophone is not common here at all. It's like all guitars, pianos. So, I mean, that's a very good opportunity for me to become a saxophone rock star here. Ooh. Just learned Careless Whisper last night.
Maybe that's how we close the episode.
Yeah, we could edit it in. We can do an Instagram post of me just jamming out here, Careless Whisper. Yeah, it was fun. So I found a saxophone store. They have like a tenor sax, a soprano sax. So I was playing those while I was waiting. And boy, did I like it.
Also, I'm very happy that he brought it, because that's what motivated me to bring my ukulele. Him taking an entire bag, so shout out to Walker.
Yeah.
And I've played my ukulele so much here. Yeah, so
loved it.
And they're probably really annoyed of it by now. But
no, it's great, dude.
I saw that, man. Don't think I didn't see. I think one of the last things was we went to a teacher meetup where it was like kind of like a teacher hangout through Ninja Teacher for current teachers and or current students of the teacher certification course, as well as past students. So into that, we got to meet some new people that are in the current course. But one thing that was kind of funny or noticeable was, you know, we just got back from this meeting is in like downtown, right? So where everybody's at, whereas we were living in like kind of the outskirts in like a cheap area of town. And so we go to this bar and it's like 80,000 dong for a drink, which is like...
The drinks were really good.
Yeah. And it was like $80,000 per drink, which is like $3.
Three something.
But here we are, we're only willing to get one. Oh, that is so expensive.
We're coming from 13 cent beer.
Yeah, yeah. You know. So it's pretty funny. We just weren't willing to get more than one drink. But
A side note. So I am now 7 days into a sober month. This is something I did back in the U.S. It would have been last year.
2 years ago, mate.
2 years ago? 20-something, 20-aught, whatever. But anyways, I did a sober month during the beginning of football season. And if you know Iowa football, it's a very heavy, heavy drinking scene. So it was a good social experiment for me. I'm doing it again now. It's 7 days in. I really wanted to drink the other night at that teacher meetup, but I didn't.
And this guy's such a nerd,
now
man.
It's been smooth sailing.
Doesn't even drink.
So we'll see. I'll write something up and kind of compare and contrast my experience before with my experience now. Evan's been trying to kiss me like all week, which has been really thrilling for me.
Thrilling.
Yeah. No, I think, I mean, unless you guys have anything else, I think that's a good place to end it.
No, I think I'm good. We could show just briefly just the like
little panorama. Yeah, panorama.
Okay, here we go. A little panoramic of our view from the house.
It's a nice little place. It's a really quiet neighborhood.
I'm taking the mic, even though it doesn't matter. I just don't want the cord. So, yeah, so this is the view from our house. And you can see, usually there's a kid that's studying in that window all day, every day, usually for like 4 hours. That's our front gate down there. Yeah, over here. And actually, the airport is over that way, so we can watch planes take off.
I think you should wait until the plane takes off.
Oh, yeah, we'll just sit here for another 20 minutes or so. Yeah, just keep your eye on the sky. Also, the only white guy in the neighborhood lives in the top left of that tall building.
He's pointing on the camera, not at the screen.
Right there. That's where Robin lives. He's from England. So the other white guy. Anyway,
he's been spying on us.
That's our place, so. Warrior. Thanks for joining us.
Peace.